Maggie was born in 1913 in a windy little town that you've probably seen. She grew up smart and she grew up hard, tried to do her best just to make her mark. When Maggie went dancing with the girls from town, she'd find a young man and spin him around. She'd steal your spoons and say your part and leave your jaw on the floor right next to your heart. She had opinions. Cause she'd hate you if you're black and she'd hate you if you're white. She'd hate you if you're a Jap or a Kraut or a dyke. She'd hate you if you're big and she'd hate you if you're small. There's no discrimination cause she hated them all. She was all about equality. Now one night when the songs were relatively slow, Maggie slunk into the arms of a soldier named Joe. Said, "You're handsome and you're quiet and you don't act a fool. If you drive a car and have a job, I guess you'll do." So she married him. Now Thanksgiving Day was always a treat. Maggie'd make a mean meal that couldn't be beat. She'd stand aside and watch you eat, and by the end of the dinner you couldn't see your feet. And then things got interesting. Fighting started in not shortly after that. Maggie had the whole family grab their baseball bats. The men would break bottles and the women would cry, and Maggie'd stand back grinning with a gleam in her eye. Well, she always loved Thanksgiving. Now when the family went away and she said goodbye to Joe, Maggie moved herself into an old folks' home where the walls of the halls all stank of the past, and if the people tried to get away, they couldn't go fast. She always caught him. Now Admiral Mack had the run of the place. Had a serpent for a tongue and a hatchet for a face. His wheelchair made targets of all the nurses' feet. No orderly was safe and no day was complete without incident. One day the Admiral was riding on the lift, and Maggie jumped aboard. He tried to start a rift, but a Hellcat blew him down with a few choice words. Now he's gentle as a rabbit and sweet as a bird in the springtime. Now when Maggie lay down in her dying room, the priest said, "Don't you worry, sis, you'll be with Jesus soon." Maggie shot a smile far and wide, said, "If you believe that, Padre, you're a bigger fool than I." And then she died. Now Maggie left this world most eagerly. She was spitting in the clouds over Mick Henry. And when Jesus and the devil tried to take her home, she smacked them both upside the head, said, "I'm better on my own. Hands off, you two." Now I think of Hellcat Maggie from time to time, whenever there's food and whenever there's wine. I see her bony fingers and familiar assault, saying if you don't get what you want, then it's your own damn fault. She really meant that too. So let's raise a glass to this one tough lady with a little old toast that Maggie used to say. Friends, here's to those that wish us well. Those who don't can go to hell. And that's the story of Hellcat Maggie.